my dream did come true that night. And here we are. We're here at Disneyland. Right here. This is where it all began, where it all started. This right here at the train station is where I met my wife. So let's take a look at it. Right here. Disneyland Railroad. Population 650 million. Wow. Elevation 138 feet. Destination, love. So this is exactly where it happened. This has a special place in my heart, even though it's just a train station. So this is it, this is the exact spot. There's a train coming in right here, but this is the exact spot right here. I was hanging out with friends, and I sat with them, playing with their kids, playing with my friends that I met from Mouse Wait. Then we got on to this train. Oh, it is this one. This is the train with the seats that go forward instead of sideways. It was called the sweeper train. It goes around to every station and picks the last people up to bring them back to Main Street Station. And then, last second, one more person, and then she hops on. She sits right in front of me and steals the two kids I was playing with, steals them and their attention. And I'm just sitting there, kind of awkwardly, but then I kind of recognize her, not from her face because she covered her face in her Mouse Wait profile. I remember her from her Wookiee beanie. Like, oh my gosh, it's Ipoca, because she looked like Pocahontas. I said, oh my gosh, it's Ipoca. She's famous on Mouse Wait. So I got nervous, and then I went to exchange numbers, and I took my phone out, and my phone died. I was like, no, my phone died. And then what happened was, after we got off of the train, we went down here to these benches. And then we were just hanging out, we were talking, and I was like, hey, this person's pretty cool. Let's exchange numbers. And then we exchanged numbers, and then we headed off. We left, and I was like, dang it, I wish I could have gotten her number. But I put my number in her phone, and then I was like, okay, I'll just wait for her to text someday, sometime. And then that was that. So I went back home, and then I was just sitting in my bed thinking, oh no, she hasn't texted or called me back yet so that I could get her number. And then I stalked her on Foursquare. If you don't remember what Foursquare was, it was an app where you check in. It's mainly to check in. And then some restaurants say, hey, if you check in here, you get a free soda or you get 5% off. And then it shows your friends where you checked in. It's pretty cool with your friends. But then I used it to see mutual friends to find Mrs. LaTruce on Foursquare, and then I messaged her. I said, I was thinking, oh man, it's been an hour and a half and she hasn't texted me. What a creep. It's been an hour and a half and she hasn't texted me. And let me find her. I found her on Foursquare, and I messaged her. I said, hey, just in case, this is a public comment too. This was not like a DM. This is a comment on where she checked in last, which was like Newport Beach. And I said, hey, just in case I didn't put my number in right, here's my number again. So I put my phone number in her comments, and then she texted me, and I was like, yes, I'm in. But this is what, like, I didn't like her yet. I was just like, oh, this is a cool person. We could hang out in the future. And then that night we had a text. Texting battle, a pun battle. With whales, with pictures of whales, because iMessage had bubbles, and if you put eyes on it, it looks like a whale. And let me show you that. So we had like Whaley Potter, or Prince of Wales, or Dolphinately Try, and Sure It Is, all those puns. We had a pun battle, and at the end, I was like, you know what? You beat me this time. And that was the first time I met who would become my wife eventually. Just right there. You know, magic does happen. So for the next month or so, we would just hang out and do stuff with the group of friends and everything. On Valentine's Day, I said, hey, whoever sees me first from Mouse Wait gets to have a drink with me. And it just so happens she found me, and then we had this awkward toast. Then came February 29th. It was Leap Day. And it was Disney's first 24-hour day that they did. And you had to fall in this huge line. And I went around giving mouse waiters some donuts. And really, I think I had a group targeted to give my donuts to.
and then they ended up winning the donuts, and then we get in and we just go together. And throughout this whole experience, this was like about 2 days because it was a 24-hour period, and then the next 2 days we went to Disneyland because they were filming Modern Family. So I went with Mrs. Latrousse, and throughout those 3 days she really got me. Something, I was hooked. Like, I knew I liked her. I knew that there was something special there, even if it's just the spark of the beginning of it. I knew there was something special there, and it was just this feeling that I was like, you know what, this person's, I want to be around this person more. And that was the moment that I knew I liked her, was Leap Day, February 29th, a good day.
I remember after Gladstone's, we walked it off, had a little, nice little stroll on the beach right here. You can see water over there, boardwalk over here, sand, and well, I was all dressed up. It was like, at that time, I don't know, it was like, does she like me? Does she not? Is this a pity date? But it worked out. It worked out in the end. There's a lighthouse. And then there's this right here. I remember this. We took some pictures. Kind of awkward because I was dressed up like for a job interview. Like I was going to impress her that way. And then I was standing here. She was standing there. And then some lady was saying, take a picture. Take sexy pictures or something like that. And I was like, ah. But yeah, we took a picture right here. And then, yeah, I don't know why I thought, like, oh, if I dress like a job interview, it's like I'll win her over. And then over there is where Gladstone's is. I was telling her, like, oh man, they have some pretty good seafood, and your leftovers, they're gonna put your leftovers in a little to-go foil thing and shape it like a crab or a swan. It's so cool. And so I ordered the ahi tuna, and she ordered the chicken enchilada, because that's when I also found out that she doesn't eat seafood. And we're sitting right there, and I'm eating seafood, and she's eating chicken enchilada. And I was like, well, this date is going well already. Took her to a seafood restaurant. She doesn't eat seafood. Well, it worked out. We're married, have a house, kid, family. Yeah, so even though it started off like that, it was all good. My wife and I were like, we were really dating, we were just hanging out as friends. And then we would hang out in a lot of like Disney related things, Disney events. A lot of stuff circled around Disney, so that's why, you know, it was great to be here. It was great to have everything, like something to do all the time. If we didn't go to Disney, we went to other places, like just what's around LA and Orange County. But then we would be like hanging out, and then we just, for some reason, like friend zoned each other, or we were stuck in that what are we phase from when we met, or actually from the end of February all the way to September. We were on like, are we friends? Are we more than friends? Do we move forward? Do we like see other people or date other people, or what do we do? We were out of each of our longest relationships, and we were kind of like confused, like what do we do? Are we a thing? Are we not a thing? Man, that was a rough 9 months or 7 months of confusion. But you know what, it ended up well. Funny story at the Haunted Mansion. You know, we were hanging out, and my friend, one of my other best man, Steve, he said, I think this is the moment you could try to hold her hand at the Haunted Mansion. So when it came time, yeah, I tried to slip my hand into her hand, and I held her hand for a few seconds, and then she pulled back and said, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm just trying to hold your hand. And then she's like, why here? This is Haunted Mansion. It's scary. It's not romantic. And I'm just like, oh man. And then later that night, they said, hey everybody, let's try to hold hands with a stranger on Main Street. So like, ask them first and then to skip down Main Street. And I ended up skipping down Main Street with this lady right here. And then after that, she said, why did you do that? It's like, I just picked some random person, and Skip down Main Street with her, and then she said she was having a horrible day, and that we made her day by just holding her hand and skipping down Main Street. I didn't really hold her hand, I locked arms and went down Main Street, and you know, she wasn't having a good day, and she ended up having a great day, great night after that, kind of lifted her spirits. And here's Buzz Lightyear's Astro Blasters. Buzz Lightyear Astro Blasters. This is where I really got to show my riz. So what I told her was that I didn't know how to play. I didn't know how to get the secret high scores and everything. So I asked her, can you teach me? And then, you know, she's like, sure. So we hung out a lot of times and she taught me, quote unquote, taught me how to play Buzz Lightyear to get a high score. And then, miraculously, after her teaching me, I was able to score 2 million or 1 million consistently. And all because of her, you know? That's so like, before that, I was able to actually score 2 million. I had 2 million scores already, like, no big deal, you know? But then I wanted a reason to hang out with her so she could teach me. That was the reason. And also, and then the fact that I was able to score 2 million after she taught me, she felt so good. And felt like it was because of her. Yeah, I made her feel like it was because of her. Don't tell her though, don't tell her. But that's how we got closer together, is because she was teaching me how to win in Astro Blasters. So when we were like kind of not cool with each other, but we were cool with each other, but you know, one of those things like I like you, I hate you type of thing, but inside, you know, you like them, you just hated the fact that they have that much control over your heart. And then came the Cars Land opening. Someone offered me a ticket, and then I said, you know what, I can't go without Mrs. Latrousse. So I ended up saying, you know, I can't really go, so you could give that ticket to someone else. And then someone who ended up being our Nino at our wedding, Eddie, he said, you know what, you could take my ticket so you could invite her. So Mrs. Latrousse and I ended up going to the Cars Land premiere opening with all the celebrities. And I think that was one of the moments where we really got closer together, and we really had to think, like, what are we doing? We should be together. Mrs. Latrousse, hey, let's go to the beach. Her thinking area, Newport Beach. Maybe I shouldn't have brought her there, because if she said no, that would have ruined her thinking area. We went to the Lifeguard Tower, 23, I think, or 21. And then I got some Subway, and then I said to her, so you want to be my girlfriend or what? And she said, that was it. I was expecting something special because of all the creativity I was showing before. And it turns out being, you want to be my girlfriend or what? She was so disappointed. So I had to think of something better for the proposal. And I think I did. So as boyfriend and girlfriend, we did so many things. We were boyfriend and girlfriend for about 6.5 years or 7 years. And we went everywhere. We went to Colorado. We went to everywhere up north, San Francisco, San Diego, Las Vegas. We went everywhere that where we could drive to, pretty much. And then also maybe a couple flights here and there for other places. And we had a lot of Disneyland, a lot together, a lot with a group of friends from Mouseway, and a lot of just, man, those were the times. It was like carefree, got to do anything, go anywhere, and that was like having the time of our lives. But you know what? I still wouldn't trade that for what we have now. And this is it right here. First time both of us seeing snow fall, for real. This is the moment where I was like, that's it. I'm gonna love you forever. I wanna be with you forever. I wanna marry you. To get the ring, you know, all the guys do the research, like, oh, what's a princess cut, what's a circle, what's a arrows and triangles or whatever, and what's the V1, S21 or whatever, and you know, what kind of band, what kind of wedding band, what kind of everything. Man, months of research, months of price searching, Costco, and some places in LA. Then I finally found this like perfect ring that like spoke to me. And then once she gets the ring, she's like, yes, I would have loved anything that was just shiny. And I was like, what? All that work? Oh, man. All that work, and it was just that same thing shiny.
The proposal was so fun. We went to Canada for my birthday the year before. And then for this year, we went to Canada again so that I could propose to her at, I think it's like the Chief Lookout or something at Sea to Sky Gondola in Squamish, which is a little north of Vancouver. And we went, and the place was taken. It ended up being taken. So I ended up bringing these hearts that said, will you marry me? But I had five. I had will you marry me and a blank one. A blank one that she thought she found. So it's like, hey, let's take a picture with this heart everywhere. And then little did she know that it's on each side of the heart it said will, and it's on her side it says it was blank. And then you marry, and then at the last part I had to change it. It wasn't on the cliff side we wanted. It was a different cliff side, but more private. And then it says me. And I told her, I remember telling her, I was like, oh, I know what I want for my birthday. I want to spend the rest of my life with you. And then that's, she realized it, and she was like, oh my gosh, yes. That was amazing. And we kept the whole thing a secret. We kept it to ourselves while we were in Canada. So it was like a little secret for like 3 days that only we are celebrating, only we knew. And then we told everyone when we got home. We ended up taking our beautiful, beautiful engagement photos at City Hall in Pasadena. And I really love this place. It was really fun to do and fun to take. Awesome.
Work sent me to Bakersfield to do a couple shifts on a Thursday and a Friday. And they would pay for food, hotel, gas, and everything. So I'm like, eh, you know, I'm not doing anything. I'm not married yet. So I took it. I took that offer. And then on Friday, I was like, oh, finally I get to go home. And then my best man, Christian, says, hey, we're doing your bachelor party in San Diego tonight. So I was like, oh no, I have to go from Bakersfield all the way to San Diego. And then we had my bachelor party in San Diego. And it was really, really fun. We did the rope thing, inflatable soccer, ate at Phil's Barbecue, went to Stone Brewery. And then after that, we went to coin op and clubs. I rode a bull and everything. And then it just so happens that Mrs. Latruce also went to San Diego for her bachelorette party. Now I guess we think alike. So yeah, our first date was at Gladstone's. And a cool little thing that we didn't even notice, because we went to a lot of places to look for where we wanted to get married. We looked for a lot of places. And we ended up settling for this, not really realizing that it'd be right across the river or the bay from where our first day was at Gladstone. So there's Gladstone's right there, and then there's where our wedding was, right across the water from our first date. I was hoping we could like take some pictures over there, get on a boat, and then go on a boat here, but that didn't work. But you know, our wedding was still fun, and it's just so crazy that we didn't even think about it, and it ended up being right across the way. And there it is. We were looking at the Hotel Maya, which is right here, and then right next to it is the Reef, where we actually had our wedding. And yeah, it's really close to the Queen Mary, actually. So that was really cool. That was a really cool little factoid from our dating right there, first date, to wedding right across the way. We didn't even think about it that way, but yeah, it's funny how things work out sometimes. Another cool thing is that, so there's the venue where the ceremony and the reception happened. And then right here is where we had our hotel, where we stayed at the night before and the night after, pretty much. So we got ready in there. The groomsmen, me, the bride, the bridesmaids, everybody. And then we all just walked across this little path down here, walking seaside until we got there. And that was pretty cool. I thought that was pretty fun. And then after the wedding was done, we took our grand walk, first time as a married couple, at night down this path to go back to our room, which is which was now both of our rooms. And you know what happens? Something that we haven't had in a long time up until that marriage is good sleep, because you know, all the stress from a wedding. So we went over there, we fell asleep, knocked out because we were so tired from all the preparations from the week before and from the preparations that day, from the celebrations that day. We hadn't had good sleep until that moment. But before the good sleep, oh, a good bump. It was really cool because the first time as a married couple, we took this walk all the way from, all the way down there near the Queen Mary, all the way down here. And it was like 1 a.m. and we all took the walk as first time as a married couple. But then there was also more than half the wedding party. There was 275 people. More than half of them walked with us all the way to the hotel over here because they also had rooms, and it was pretty fun. So I'm walking towards the Hotel Maya. We really wanted the Hotel Maya. That was actually a pretty good place. But then when it all came down to it, like the cost, the amount of guests, everything considered, we had to go with the Reef. Both of them are beautiful locations. They're right next to each other, but we had to go with the Reef. That's what we went for. But look at this. This is like a banquet area, and then this is the space where you get married. And I think the thing that tipped it for me was there was a ceremony over here, and then as there was a ceremony over here, people up there were just watching from their rooms. People watching from the rooms, and it was a little awkward. And then there was a boat right here where some dude was driving by with a boat, and he was saying, he was playing all the way up really loud as they were saying, "You may kiss the bride." But look how beautiful it is right here. Ceremony right there. Strangers watching, touching themselves. And then a yacht or a boat that some guy just bought, like an old boat, comes up blasting all the way up. And then I was like, maybe something just contained to us and our guests. But yeah, this hotel is pretty nice too, but it did smell like fish. And here's another area where you could have your wedding and reception, this area down here. And this was pretty cool. This would have been nice too, but yeah, just, I don't know, we ended up going with the Reef. I've been to a wedding at the Reef before, and then I don't know what it was, but it just felt a little more, they were able to do what we needed to do for the wedding with that many people. But look at the view, look how beautiful this view is. You just step outside and look at the view. And here it is, our wedding venue, the Reef. Right now it just says the ref though, because one of the E's lights are out. Oh, you can see there's like a wedding set up a little bit there. This huge room here is where we had our reception. And then there's a rooftop area over here where we actually had the ceremony. And this is, yeah, there's, it's, it was a, it wasn't perfect the way it went about, but it was perfectly imperfect, I guess. The funny thing was, you know, we had this one person that's taking charge of all of our stuff, and they quit like 2 weeks before our wedding, so we didn't have a wedding organizer, and then they assigned us one last minute, and it was just weird. And then yeah, I think the third floor up here is where we had our ceremony, and it was overlooking the water and overlooking Gladstone's, where our first date was. Yeah, our first date was there. There's the lighthouse on the other side of the lighthouse. That was our first date. And then right here is where we got married. That arch was in the corner. We fit about 250 people up there, and it was a really, really, it was like a really fun wedding. We tried not to stress about anything. Anytime we started getting stressed, we just took a step back. And this was preparing for the wedding. During the wedding, we just didn't even care anymore. It was just like, you know what, everyone's here, everyone's having fun, let's just have fun. And then we even forgot that we had a cake. They came up to us and said, "Do you guys have a sword?" I'm like, "What? You know, a sword or a knife for the cake?" It's like, "Oh yeah, forgot. We chose a cake like 4 months ago." Yeah, this is memories. A lot of memories. 5 years ago today. And there's a lot of stories for our wedding. Like, we wanted this place. We wanted this place, and we had to kind of battle for the day and time and location. A YouTube / TV personality. We won because they decided to do his and his wife's somewhere else. Grander, I think. But yeah, that's something weird. Another thing that's weird is we had 250 people listed on our guest list. And then after that, we cut it down. And it ended up being 275 people. And then another thing, my favorite thing is that Gladstone's first date, wedding right here. And then, you know, I think everyone had fun. That was my only hope, is that everyone had fun. And I know we had fun. And we, you know, I think it was simple, but just everyone being there, it was so fun. And then we even had people from Mouseweight. We had a table for people from Mouseweight, table families, friends. And yeah, the way we did it was we took pictures by table, because it was like a buffet style. So we took pictures by table, group picture at the middle of the dance floor, and then get your food so that we could take a picture with everybody. Because man, time flies when you have a wedding. It flies so fast, and you don't even, like, you have to take a step back, stop, and just enjoy the moment, because that's the only moment you really have. You have to, everything is going. But that's so worth it. There you go, there it is, the Reef. And it was funny because we also were going over there where Queen Mary is, and then all of a sudden cars start charging at us because the parking just opened for like the Queen Mary horror tour or whatever. And then one of our friends, who we didn't know enough to invite to the wedding, was like, hey, is it them in their wedding gear? That was funny. That was funny. Now our wedding is forever Halloween theme, because Halloween stuff was going around during that time. And here is the walk back. Middle of the night, it was fun. It was like a nice breeze. Everyone in dressy clothes, and we're just walking back down this path all the way down to past that bridge, all the way to the residence inn. And it was like husband and wife. And that was like the highest moment of my life, or maybe second highest moment of my life. The daughter was born is way up there too. But yeah, that's it. That's the Reef. I had so much fun in how special but also simple it was. One of my forever memories walking down this path is my groomsman and me walking from the hotel to here. We're just goofing off, and it's just so funny when we're all just hanging out goofing off. There's Christian, Steven, David, Nelson, Marvy, Emil, Jed. Man, fun times. And then Lloyd, a really good videographer. Anthony, really good photographer. Man, that was such fun times 5 years ago. Man, time flies when you're married to the most special woman in your life.
There's a scripture found in Matthew 19, verses 5 through 6, and it reads, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. And today, the two of you become one."
The hardest part is over, let it in. Let your clarity define you in the end. We will only just remember how it feels.
Mark, I love you. I thank God Almighty for answering my prayers, for finding me one for me. You, my love.
Let it slide. Let your troubles fall behind you. Let it shine. Until you feel it all around you. And I don't mind if it's me you need to turn to. We'll get by. It's the heart that really matters in the end.
Do you like me? Check yes.
After liking each other, 9 months happened, and then we started actually being boyfriend girlfriend, and then 6 years happened, and then we were married. So our hashtags were from creeper to keeper. The other hashtag was from friend zone to end zone. It's just proof you could get out of the friend zone. So there you go. It all started at Disneyland. Then we grew together, our love grew together. Started at Gladstone's, at a place you probably didn't want to eat, and then ended up at the Reef over this bridge over here, and now it ended up in our hearts. Hashtag our souls meet where our holes meet. That's the story of our wedding for 5 years ago, and since then we took our honeymoon in Japan, came back, bought a house, had a beautiful daughter, and now we're here celebrating our 5 years.